gentlemen, dear attendees of the conference. My name is Eva Baldina Brūklīte, and it's a true pleasure for me to be here. I have been working in the field of consumer protection at the Consumer Rights Protection Center in Latvia already for more than 10 years. Since the market, the practices are constantly developing, it is never boring and always challenging to work in this area. For us as an institution, the three most important things are that consumer protection legislation is actually working in the practice, there are fair and equal conditions in the market, and that consumers are able to get a refund in cases where their rights have been violated. These three things, in my opinion, are essential for building trust in the market. Right to redress is one of the most important pillars of consumer protection. And according to a recent study done by the European Commission, the study was made on consumer detriment. Consumers suffered in total for all the six markets covered by the study, detriment of 20.3 billion from 20.3 million to 58.4 billion euros over the last 12 months in the EU. These numbers are according to the study made in 2015. Not all of the problems and the related detriment reported by consumers are caused by non-compliance with consumer law, a consumer's own assessment of whether his or her rights have been breached may not always be legally correct. However, lack of compliance with the rules is very likely an important source of consumer problems and detriment. In order to analyze this aspect further, there are three important issues which will be discussed today as well at this panel. One of the issues is related to consumer individual redress. In our opinion, one of the most important things for consumers is that they can get very fast, cheap, and efficient solutions of their disputes without lengthy and costly court proceedings. At the moment, there are two important legal acts establishing the system of alternative dispute resolutions and online dispute resolution, which ensures functioning of out-of-court dispute resolution systems. These are a directive on alternative dispute resolution and the regulation on online dispute resolution for consumer disputes. Also in Latvia, consumers are very actively using the new ADR systems, which recently have been reorganized. The numbers show that from 2,563 consumer complaints received on disputes. They were received in 2017. In 30% of cases, disputes have been solved without further proceedings. And in 29% of cases, assistance has been provided to the consumers. Furthermore, from 75 disputes examined at the Consumer Disputes Resolution Commission, 52 decisions have been adopted in favor of consumers. The numbers show that this number of disputes examined according to the new procedure is constantly raising, and it's very good tendency, because the consumers they are trusting more in this system and they are actually getting a solution of their disputes. Another important issue is related to court proceedings, and it's an issue related to cross-border court proceedings. It's always challenging for consumers to get a redress or get a refund if they have an issue with a trader cross border, and that's why it's very important that there are also some legislation in place on applicable law and jurisdiction in case of consumer disputes. The Brussels 1 regulation provides that a consumer may bring proceedings against the other party at the court of the country of his domicile, and regulation Rome 1 ensures protection for consumers that the applicable law in consumer disputes shall be the law of the country where the consumer has his habitual residence. However, in case of small claims in a small amount of disputes, there is always a problem for consumer to bring court proceedings and to get refunded. That's why I would like to mention the third issue. It's related to consumer collective redress. Unfortunately, there are so many cases where rights of a group of consumers have been violated. For example, in Latvia in 2016 and 2017, our institution found that 12 non-bank credit institutions applied to consumers larger credit extension fees than it is allowed by our legislation. And we, as an institution, estimated that consumers have suffered losses approximately in amount of 5 million euros. As a result, only four companies agreed to reimburse consumers, while rest of the companies faced fines in amount of 211,000 euros. However, the majority of consumers have not been reimbursed in this case. So far, at the European level, this topic of collective redress has been covered by the Commission recommendation of 11 June 2013 on collective redress. But unfortunately, this recommendation is just a soft law, and there is no obligation to implement it in the legislation, which is the case in Latvia as well. But there is some light in the end of the tunnel, and at the moment there is a new proposal within a framework of a new deal for consumers, which is intending to fix the situation. This proposal contains a new directive on injunctions and collective redress in various areas, including the one on consumer protection. And to conclude, I can emphasize that at the moment the consumer legislation is in place, but still the mechanisms on consumer individual and collective redress need to be developed, and especially the binding mechanism of collective redress should be stipulated in the EU law and introduced in the practice. Thus, the market conditions will be more fair for both parties, consumers and traders. With this, I would like to conclude, and I would like to thank you for your attention, and I would like to give the floor for the speakers. Thank you.